In this lesson, we want to add some signage to the trash and recycle cans. The idea is to add a logo to the back face and the trash recycle title to the front. I am going to introduce you to UVW Unwrapping. Unwrapping allows you to map textures onto the geometry in a more precise way. UVs provide a coordinate system to be able to map 2D images onto 3D geometry. Since unwrapping is a pretty deep topic, we'll keep it simple. Start by selecting the trash can. Then, from the modifier list, add the unwrap UVW modifier. In the selection section of the modifier, select the Select by Element button. Now, select the trash can object. This will select all the polygons on the trash can in one click. In the Edit UVs section, select the Open UV Editor. The view window displays the UVWs in the 2D space of the map superimposed over a grid. It is important to keep all the UVs inside the grid square. In the Explode section of the editor, select the Flatten by Polygon Angle button. This creates UV mapping coordinates for the object based on its shape. Notice how the UVs look as if they are panels taken off the model itself. This will help greatly in creating a map for it. Now select all the UVs. In the toolbar, use the Rotate tool and rotate the UVs negative 90 degrees. Most of these UVs we won't be using. The two where we want the text and logo are the two UVs on the right of the grid. Now we need to export the UVs as an image to use in an image editor to line up things in the design. Go to Tools, Render UVW Template. Leave the parameters at the default and select Render UV Template. The UVs will render as white lines on a black background. Save the file by clicking on the Save icon in the upper left corner of the image. This UV template image will need to be taken into an image editing program like Photoshop to create the texture. If you lay out the desired design elements using the flattened wire in the UV template as a guide, the texture should fit perfectly on the model when finished and used on a material in the scene. Here's an example of the texture for the trash can. Now, let's create a material for it. In the slate, create a physical material. Double-click on the base color input socket and apply the trash_color.jpg. Change the material mode to advanced and change the reflections amount to 0.5. Assign the material to the trash can and display the map in the viewport. Now we will repeat the same procedures on the recycle can. This time, with a little sped up video playback as a review of the process, since it is identical to what we did with the trash can. This time, though, we need to use the recycle_color.jpg bitmap image for the base color map of the recycle bin. Assign and show the map in the viewport, and we're done. Unwrapping the train models to flatten the UVs is how the textures for the train were completed. To add those unwrapped bitmaps to the train, you only need to create the material, add the unwrapped image to the base color and apply the material to the appropriate part of the train. As an example, select the Engineer Cab object. In the Slate Material Editor, create a physical material in the view. Double-click on the Base Color Input Socket. Navigate to the Images folder and select the Engineer Cab Hull underscore color dot PNG. Change the material mode to Advanced. Change the reflections to 0.5 and the roughness to 0.1. Select the Apply Material to Selected button to apply to the object and click Show Map in Viewport. Rename the material Engineer Cab Hull. Continue to add materials to the remainder of the train. You can clone the Engineer Cab Hull material by holding Shift and moving in the slate. Rename the material and replace the base color map with the next train bitmap. Here you can watch as I apply the map for the train engineer's door by applying Engineer Cab Door.png to the base color of the copied material. This way we don't need to set up the reflection parameters again, and we're assured that the material will match. Once it's done, simply apply to the door geometry and make sure to turn on the map display in the viewport. Using the guide provided with the download assets, match the maps to the other train objects and continue making duplicate materials until the train is completely textured. Now that the train has textures, it is more obvious that the windows on the train are black. Time to explore creating glass. The great thing about physical materials are those templates. The templates set basic parameters for a material based on the chosen template to get you on the road to the desired material. We'll start there. Add a physical material to the view. Change the template to Glass Thin Geometry. Then adjust your viewport so you can see the windows on the train. Then rename the material Glass. Go to the main toolbar and from the Selection Set drop-down menu, choose Windows. Now apply the glass material to the windows using the Apply Material to Selection. Adjust your viewport so you can see the windows on the train. Render this viewport. You can see the windows are glass, and you can see a bit of reflections, but it doesn't look very realistic. This is because the renderer we are using is the Scanline renderer. It is a versatile and fast renderer, but it isn't the best choice when rendering more realistic reflections and any advanced material. We need to change to use another renderer. We will cover rendering in later lessons, but for now, go to the main toolbar and open the Render Settings dialog. From the Renderer drop-down menu, choose the Art Renderer. The Art Renderer is a physically based renderer that is fast and works with most materials, but is especially powerful with the physical material. As an example, on the left is the Scanline renderer, and on the right is the same viewport rendered with the Art Renderer. The only change that was made between the images, the exposure in the scene had to be turned up a bit to make it brighter in the Art Render. It is clear how superior the reflections look in the Art Render. It is fast, but it will take more time than the Scanline. If you render your scene with Art compared to the Scanline Renderer, it will be dark, A little like this. To get it to be brighter as the scanline renderer, we can adjust the exposure control. Go to the rendering menu and open environment. In the exposure control section, choose linear exposure control from the drop-down menu. Render the scene. Things should look brighter now. The next thing we want to do is add some chrome material to the lamps. Select the lamp hanging over the ticket booth door. In the slate, create a physical material and rename it lamp metal. From the template list, choose polished aluminum and then assign the material to the lamp object and render. And the material you'll see is way too shiny and bright for the look we want for the train station. In the material parameters, in base color section, select the color swatch and change the color to a dark gray. That is the beauty of the templates, as they only require simple changes to get the material to what you need. Now render, and the lamp looks much nicer. Apply the same material to the remaining lamps. The large support that hangs over the train is a simple gray. Let's create a cool metal material and add a bump to give it some pop. Add a physical material to the slate view. Rename the material support. Add the support geo color PNG to the base color map. Apply it to the support object. Press Show Map in Viewport button so that the image shows on the object in the viewport. It looks a little low quality, but it won't render that way. Add the support geo bmp.png to the bump map section. Also, grab the output socket of the support bump and plug it into the input socket for reflectivity map. Render to see how it looks. If the scene is too bright, go into the render menu environment and in the exposure control section, set it to no exposure control. Now back to the support material. In the reflection section, set metalness to 1.0. Metalness is how much the material reacts like a metallic surface. Metal surfaces reflect light more directly, preventing light rays from penetrating or scattering into the surface. When compared to a non-metal material that would have a lower metalness value, change the roughness to 0.2. This value will soften the reflections. Render the viewport. You can see it looks pretty good. Materials and lighting and rendering all go hand in hand, and we will explore these further in later lessons.